Hey everyone, it's Sarah with Spicy Pinecone, and I am back to show you guys how I'm going to make a Valentine's Day soap. The fragrance oil that I'm going to be using is strawberries and champagne. It's a Crafter's Choice fragrance, so it's from Wholesale Supplies Plus. It smells really, really good. I've got some melt and pour strawberries right there that I'm going to be putting on the top, and also probably doing a little bit of piping. Okay, so now I'm getting my lye solution going. I wanted to use heavy cream for my liquid. So what I'm doing is just kind of getting it all mixed together. I've also got a little bit of silk, and it's kind of tricky to add silk when you have milks or you have cubes, frozen ice cubes, because you have to make sure that your silk completely dissolves. So it can be a little bit tricky, but it can be done. I do it a lot. Also over here, I have my hard oils. They're melting down. I have them in a glass bowl on top of a pot with boiling water. So it's kind of my makeshift double boiler right here. My liquid oils are all sitting in a paint mixing bucket. And I like using the paint mixing bucket because it's very inexpensive. It's flexible and easy to use. So once these have all melted down, I will add them to my liquid oils, and I'll come back once my lye solution's ready and my oils have been melted and combined. Now this is just, I'm going to add a teeny bit of my liquid oils. I have not added my melted hard oils to my liquid ones yet. I'm going to let it cool down just a little bit, and no reason for that other than I just wanted to add some all liquid to the colorants, because what I have had a problem with in the past is when I added the melted hard oils to the liquid oils and then let it sit in my colorants for a while. Depending on what it was really bad with the lard. But when it cooled, if it sat for 15 minutes or longer, it would start to cool and solidify in the cups. So now all I do is use only liquid oils in my colorants. Now this is a frother tool. I'm not sure if you can see that. And so in this one I have titanium dioxide, and what you want to do is you want to mix it up before you turn on your frother, or else it will puff up everywhere, make a big old mess. And this just helps to break up the clumps. But with titanium dioxide, even using a frother, sometimes I have a problem with clumps. So when I add it to my soap batter, when I'm ready to color the white part, I run this mixed part through a little tiny tea strainer, and that helps catch any chunks that I may have missed. But okay, there's the white, and I also got some new colorants in the mail yesterday. I've been waiting for them. I have they're from Nurture Soap Supplies. I have Vibrant Pink that I'm using for my strawberries and champagne soap. And I also have the Vibrance Red. Anyway, my oils and my lye is at about the same temperature. And I'm going to go ahead and combine them. I'm going to add my fragrance oil. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and separate my colors. I'm adding my titanium dioxide to the part that I want white. And the little tea strainer just helps keep out any rogue chunks that try to make their way into the batter. And There's my Vibrance Pink and my Vibrance Red. These didn't come out as dark as I wanted them to be. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to grab two more cups. I'm going to grab my red and my pink. Do the lighter color first. So pink. And then red. All I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of batter from the pink in there, a little bit of batter from the red in this one. It does not have to be perfect because you're going to mix it all in with the stick blender anyway. Just kind of give it a little teeny stir. Now I'm going to separate my frosting. And this, there's not really going to be any rhyme or reason to this. I'm just going to kind of blob it in. And then what I want to do is kind of do a spoon swirl thing. You can hear my kids having a great time right now. I'm gonna go pound this on the ground real quick. And if you can see inside, she's kind of blobbing in there. This is just a little bamboo, well, it's kind of a chopstick. It came with my wok. I don't really know what they expected me to use it for, but I said, you know what? That looks like a good soap making thing. And that's usually what I do when I see weird stuff. Use it for soap. Okay, I'm gonna go bang the top again. Now it looks really severe right now, but when I pound it out again, it'll calm down. Looks like a big, angry, spiky Valentine's mohawk right now. See, this is already perfect consistency for piping. And I'm not sure if you can see, I'm using a little circle tip. I know, bad soaping practice. You're not supposed to take off your gloves, but it's so much easier to put the embeds on this way. All right. And that's it.